Welcome to the Top Listing Agent Show, the place to be to stay on the cutting edge of what it takes to sell more homes in less time. Each week, your host, Chadi Bazzi, will share with you the best skill sets, systems, and strategies so you can become a top listing agent. And now, let the show begin.
Hey there, Chadi Bazzi here. Welcome to another episode of the Top Listing Agent Show. First of all, I want to begin today by just saying thank you to every person that's been commenting on our YouTube videos, engaging with our content on Facebook, and for those of you who have already gone and given us a five-star, you know, rating and a positive review on iTunes. I really, really, really appreciate you. Your comments, your engagement with us is what keeps me going. And today I'm gonna talk to you about a very, very important topic that not too many people really talk about out there. And it really has nothing to do with business, but has everything to do with business. And it's based on a quote that like literally changed my life, I'd say approximately about 15 years ago or so, when I was going through a similar situation as I'm going through right now on a personal level. And basically, it's all about focus. But the quote was, when you focus on your problems, your goals go away. And when you focus on your goals, your problems go away. So what I'm seeing out there, specifically lately, as I've been speaking on a one-on-one basis with a lot of you out there, you know, via social media, via telephone, text messaging, etc., is a lot of people are more focused on the problem than they are focused on the solution. And I'm telling you, something one of my coaches told me a long time ago, he said, the best drug in the universe is focus. That's the best drug, that's the best high, is focus. And you know exactly what I'm talking about. When you're focused, when you are in the zone, you're feeling good, you're taking positive actions every single day, you're making things happen, abundance opens up its doors to you, and it's like everything's just happening. Like you're just magnetic, you're vibrating, you know, a very good energy, and everything's just coming to you. And then all of a sudden, it stops. And the reason it stops is because you encounter a little obstacle, you encounter a little challenge, whether that be personal or whether that be business related, it don't matter. It's just that when you encounter that, what do? You stop focusing on everything that led up to whatever successes you were achieving, and all of a sudden, you are in breakdown mode. You are in breakdown mode and everything completely stops. So again, the quote is, when you focus on your problems, your goals go away. And when you focus on your goals, your problems go away. So you can replace the word problem with obstacle, with a challenge, with a setback, with whatever. You know what I'm talking about. You need to stop focusing on that and focus on the solution. And the focus on the solution is to control your focus. So what I'm gonna do now is I wrote down a couple of things that you can begin to do like immediately to have more control over your focus. I put down step number one is control your focus. Control your focus. Easier said than done. And the reason I say it's easier said than done is because anyone can say, you know, I'm focused, I'm gonna control my focus. But if you don't have a step-by-step process, then you're not gonna be able to control your focus. And if you do, you're only gonna be able to control it momentarily, maybe for, you know, minutes, maybe for hours, maybe for a day, and then you're just gonna go back to your old way of being, okay? So how do we control our focus? So first of all, let me ask you a question. I want you to think about the answer to this question. The question is, what do I feel like eating tomorrow for dinner? What are you focused on now? What you want to eat for dinner tomorrow, okay? So basically what I'm trying to demonstrate to you here is that you control your focus by the questions you ask yourself. You control your focus by the questions you ask yourself. So if you ask yourself focus-driven questions, guess what happens? You alter your focus, you own your focus in that moment, and you can get in the zone. So I wrote down some questions that I want you to write down, and I want you to begin to ask yourself, like, literally all day, every single day, or pretty much anytime you feel like your mind is going in the gutter. Question number one you want to write down is the following. What is my number one goal right now? What is my number one goal right now? Okay, you gotta have, I mean, we all have a lot of goals, but what is your number one goal right now? Like, you gotta have a number one big, sexy goal. What is your number one goal right now? Now, so when you ask yourself, what is my number one goal right now, and you know what your number one goal is, guess where your mind is going to shift its focus to? The number one goal. So now, instantly, you've shifted your focus from wherever your focus was to now being focused on the goal. But that's not enough. We got to carry it further by asking this next question. The next question is, what can I do now that will bring me closer to my goal? What can I do right now in this moment to bring me closer to my goal? And this goes back to a previous episode that we talked about on goal setting, when we said most people just write goals. But what I want you to do is, once you identify the goal, you need to identify the activities that you have to engage in day in and day out to be able to reach the goal. So you just go back to that list of activities, and or if you don't know what those activities are, you need to create those activities immediately, and you need to write them down, and you need to engage in them like pretty much every single day. The goal isn't just going to happen by itself because you believe in the law of attraction and you think you're a highly vibrating, magnetic, positive, goal-getting kind of person. You got to know what actions you got to engage in, and you got to engage in those actions each and every single day. So question number two was, what can I do now to get me closer to that goal? Question number three. Question number three is, who do I need to be right now to be the man or woman who can achieve the goal? See, now there's a difference between action and being, okay? Because while you are engaging in action, who you are being in that moment determines the results you're gonna get from that action. So for instance, if you are in action and you're not like feeling good versus you are in action while feeling good, which one's gonna produce a better result? The one where you're feeling good. So who do I need to be right now to be the man or woman who can achieve the goal? You know, things that come to mind would be like, I need to be energetic, I need to be positive, I need to be a go-getter, I need to be disciplined, I need to be determined, I need to be courageous, I need to be powerful, etc., etc., etc. These words. Now, look where your focus is on now. These words. And then what do? You take that list of words and you just affirm them. I am powerful. I am fearless. I am the best. Who I am is a go-getter. People love me. I have high energy. I do whatever it takes. I'm a doer, etc., etc., etc. Do you see what we just did by asking ourselves just a few questions? We altered our state of mind. We altered our way of being. We altered our energy. We altered our focus. And now we are out there taking the right action with the right feeling, and we are going to create a right result. Guys, that's step number one. Step number two is a daily ritual that I've been talking a lot about. And if you're already a member of our Top Listing Agent Facebook group, that private community, if you're not, you need to go to toplistingagentgroup.com and you need to join us. It's free. It's where you see people doing certain things every single day, talking about certain things, and, you know, just all growing together to become top listing agents in our community. And that daily ritual is the ritual of activating magic in your life. Activating magic in your life. What we're talking about is journaling every single day. A simple process that takes anywhere between 1 to 3 minutes every single morning that will get you to be in a better state of mind all day, every single day. So I'm gonna go very quickly on this 5-step process. You could check it out on another episode, or you can join our group and see a bunch of people doing it every single day. It's get a sheet of paper every single day. Begin by answering this question. What made me happy in the last 24 hours? So that way you take your mind immediately to happiness in your life. Question number two, what are two things I am grateful for? Question number three is, what are my top three personal goals? You write them down every single day, so you're focused on your goals. Number four, you write down four affirmations. Number five, you write down your income goal in the present tense, five times. You do that every single day in writing, not typing, in writing every single day. And I challenge you to do that for the next 30 days straight. And I promise you magic will appear in your life. You'll be a much more focused person. And the final point right here is I put down hang out and stay connected with focus driven goal achieving people. Hang out and stay connected with focus driven goal achieving people. We say we are a product of our environment. If you are engaging in a conversation with one of your more comedic, happy friend, and that friend is telling jokes and laughing and smiling, do you think that is going to have any impact on your mood, on your focus in that moment? Absolutely. Now, what if you're hanging out with someone that's always complaining about the marketplace? You know, people in your office, people complaining like, oh, my deal's falling apart. The buyer's, running me all over town. They're not writing on offers, lowball offers. The seller is not realistic. He wants $100,000 more than what his property is worth. If you're hanging around with people like that, and they're constantly having that conversation. What are they doing? They're putting fear in your mind. They're putting doubt in your mind. They're poisoning your mind. And you're responsible for that because you're allowing yourself to be in the environment of those who don't really serve you in going to the next level, okay? And then what if you're hanging around every single day, like in our Listings On Demand, our flagship program. By the way, you need to check that out by going to listingsondemand.com. Those are the people who are every single day hanging out together virtually inside a Facebook group. There's people that are just going live and doing their prospecting every single day. What if you get a notification on your phone that says, hey, Marvin Gomez is doing his live prospecting right now. And you get to sit down and watch this guy do his prospecting and is talking to expireds and talking to for sale by owners. And, he's standing up. He's excited. You see that person. That becomes a part of your environment. You're now instantly inspired. You're now instantly reminded that that's the action that you need to be involved in. What if you see a bunch of people writing their journal every single day and posting it inside that group? What are you going to do? You're reminded of an activity that you got to engage in that we just talked about in step number two. What if you're hanging out with people who are like, well, I just used this line and I was able to set an appointment, etc., etc., etc. You are a product of your environment and you are responsible for your environment. So you can be in one of three different environments. You can be in environment number one with the negative people, environment number two with the positive people, and then there's another environment that a lot of people don't talk about, and that's the environment where you spend more time by yourself than you do with others. And that right there, my friends, is a very dangerous place. That right there is a very dangerous place because left to your own devices, you create confusion and you lose control. I'm saying have your one-on-one time with yourself, but where the category that I want you to spend the majority of your time in is virtually or personally, physically, is with goal-achieving, determined, focused, go-getters. That's where you need to focus the majority of your time. So let's do a little recap. What we talked about here is when you focus on your problems, your goals go away. And when you focus on your goals, your problems go away. So the bottom line is you are the solution. Number one, I want you to control your focus by controlling the questions you ask yourself. Number two, I want you to engage daily in the five-step daily journaling process. And number three is I want you to identify and begin to hang out with people who are doing all the things that you want to do. Therefore, I invite you into our community, our Listings On Demand community. If you want to be around people who are happy, goal-driven, goal-achieving, go-getters, then what I want you to do is I want you to reach out to me via Facebook, private messenger, and say, hey, Chadi, can you and I have a one-on-one conversation? And I'd love to have that one-on-one conversation with you. Or you can simply just go to tlastrategycall.com and book it directly into my schedule there. So thank you very much for watching this video and or listening to this podcast episode. I appreciate you, and I can't wait to hear your feedback on this episode. Take care, everyone. Bye-bye.